Let's see how we can create or refer to a specific range in Excel by using row and column numbers. Or I would say how we can create a dynamic range in Excel using simple VBA code. So here you can see that I have data on sheet named total data. In this data, I have sales data from month Jan to November. And in column A, I have product IDs. So this data I have till row number 52. And this data is starting from row number 3. So we can say that sales data is from row number 3 to row number 52. And sheet name is total data. Now if I move to next sheet named as sheet 2, here I have just one product ID, and task is that for this product ID I want to search total data on another sheet in column A, and if this product ID is found, then I want to copy only data from June to November and then paste this data to sheet 2 in front of this product ID. So this task I want to complete with VBA code, and I'll try to explain how we can create dynamic range to copy only a specific range, not the entire row. So I have already written VBA code on command button, which we can see here. So once I click on this command button, it is doing the same task. So let me show you what is the VBA code that I have used here. I'll go to developer tab and then I click on design mode so that I can double click on check the code that I have written on the back end of this command button. So let me double click on this command button. So this is the VBA code that I have used for this task. So let me explain this code. First of all, I have declared three variables: dim, my range as string, and then range1 rng1 as a string, comma range2 rng2 as string. So these three variables are of string type. I will use them. And then next line is search underscore value. This is also a variable. I have not defined this variable because in VBA what happens if we don't define variable of any type, then whatever value we store, that type of variable considers itself. So search value is a variable where I am storing worksheets sheet 2, where we have just one product ID, dot cells, and that product ID is in cell C3, that means row number 3, column number 3, dot value. So let me show you where we have this value. I'll go to sheet 2, and here we have product ID, single product ID in C3. Now I'll activate the sheet where we have large data or total data. Sheet name is total data. So worksheets in brackets within inverted commas sheet name dot activate. Once we have activated this sheet where we have total data, then data is from row number 3 to row number 52. We can change these numbers according to the volume of data. So this for loop will run from row number 3 to row number 52. Then I have used one if condition. If worksheets total data dot cells Here I need to specify row, comma, column. So row, I have used variable of loop, that is I. Column is A, where we have all the product IDs on sheet named total data. Let me show you. So we have column A where we can see all the product IDs are there. Dot value equal to search underscore value. So this is the variable that we have used to store search value from sheet number 2 or sheet 2. Then what should happen? So this is the logic. Actually, once we have matched the search value on total data sheet, we want to copy part of range. So ideally I should have written dot range and then from G3 to L3. This range I want to copy. Let me show you. Row number 7. I want to copy G7, not G3. G7 to L7. So this row number 7 is decided by loop. So what I have done here? I want to use G7 to L7. So instead of using this, what I have done, I have used G as it is, RNG1 equal to in inverted commas G and then I. So I will decide about 7 or wherever value is matched. So let me delete this. So if worksheets total data dot cells I comma 1 dot value is equal to search value, then what should happen? Range 1 equal to G3. I have used G and I for column number. Range 2 equal to L and I for column number. And then my range that I want to copy is by concatenating, and this is the logic to concatenate. So we can learn here. Range 1 space sign of ampersand or and space inverted commas colon space again sign of and or ampersand space and range 2. So product of this line is equal to dot range G7 to L7. So instead of using a static range, here in this logic we have freedom to use the column number and we can use it according to the requirement. Once we have created or stored the final value in my range variable, then from worksheets total data dot range my range dot select, I am selecting this range, and then selection dot copy. Then once data is copied or the part of or the dynamic range is copied, I will again activate sheet 2 where I want to paste, and I want to paste in front of product ID. So that cell is D3 here in this example. Let me show you. On sheet 2, I want to select D3 and then paste data. So to select D3, code is worksheets sheet 2 dot range in brackets within inverted commas D3 dot select, and then simple code selection dot paste special space paste equal to Excel paste all skip blanks equal to false and transpose equal to false. Then I am closing if statement here and then closing looping statement with keyword next. Once it is done, then one line for making application dot cut copy mode equal to false, and once task is done, I want compiler or cursor to be there in cell C3. So for that I have written line worksheets sheet 2 dot cells 3,3 dot select. So let me do some formatting. So this is the complete simple VBA code that we can use to copy part of range, or we can use only this part to create logic for creating or referring range driven by row and column numbers. You can pause this tutorial here. You can note down this VBA code and practice at your own. So let me go to sheet again and click on this command button. We can see that data or product ID is searched or looked into total data sheet and part of range is being copied and pasted in front of this product ID. So we can use this VBA code for single value search and referring to dynamic range, and logic is very simple and it gives us liberty to select any range by row and column number is completely dynamic by using variable of loop. And here in this line we are adding these two variables to make final range. If you have more than one values to search and get results in the same manner, we can use one additional for loop outside this loop. Outside this for loop, we will use one more loop if we have more than one values to search. I hope this tutorial is helpful. You can use this code in different task automations with some changes into it. For any question around this topic, you can write into comments or send me emails. And please subscribe to my channel for more VBA tutorials.